Hi everyone, how do you do? Today I'm going to show you two hacks of filter function that I use a lot in my jobs. In the first part, I'm gonna explain how to define multiple conditions in the filter function. In the second part, you will learn how to return non-adjacent columns with the filter function. If you don't know anything about the filter function, please first, watch this video. The link is in the description. All right, let's get started. I have the sale amounts of food products in four different countries. I want to filter this list with two conditions. I only want to see the information of garlic sauce products which have sold more than average. In this case, the first condition and second condition should be true. Did you hear me? I used first condition and second condition. But since the returning result is an array, I can't use the AND function because the AND function only represents one result. I have to use a trick which its result is an array. First, let me calculate each condition individually. In this cell, I type equal filter. I want to return the entire table, comma. The condition is the products that are equal to garlic sauce, enter. For the average, I repeat the process. If I double click on the first filter, and select the include section in the argument, I can see the true and false results, which are dependent to the condition, and Excel only returns the true results. If I repeat this for the second filter, you can see the true and false results for this section too. I have to find a way to combine these two conditions together. Let me show you how. First, let me bring these true and false results of each condition to these cells. It's better. We have two conditions and we want to filter the list if the first condition and the second condition results are true. In mathematical operations, Excel considers true as number 1 and false as 0. Let's see what happens if we multiply these two arrays together. I type equal, select this array, and multiply it by this array. We only get number 1 in these two rows because the condition in both of them was true. As I told you, Excel considers false as 0 and true as number 1. If you look at this section, false is multiplied by true, and the result is 0. And in here, false is multiplied by false, that gives us the 0. And finally, true is multiplied by true, and the result is 1. Okay, the problem is solved. We learned if we multiply both conditions together, we will get the winning result. But what if I tell you I want to filter the list for the garlic sauce product or the products that have sold more than the average? What do you think? What should I do? When we say or, if one of the conditions is true, the result is true. We only get false if both conditions are false. So what do you think I have to use instead of the asterisk sign? I have to use plus. I type equal this array plus this array. You can see the results. Remember, you are not restricted only to two conditions. You can define as many conditions as you need. Okay, let's type in the function equal filter. I want to return all the columns, comma. For the include section, since we have two conditions, we have to put each condition between parentheses. The first condition is if the product is equal to garlic sauce. Close the parentheses and multiply it with the second condition. If the sale amount is greater than average. Close the parentheses, enter. Now I can see the results. But if I change the asterisk sign to the plus, you can see the results for garlic sauce or above average. If you think the first part of this video was helpful, please give it a thumb up. And if you want to watch videos like this, please subscribe to the channel. Okay, let's get back to the next part. In this example, we have two conditions. We want to filter the list and see the information of India or USA. And I only want to return these three columns. I type equal filter. For the array section, if the returning columns were beside each other, I could easily select them. But in this case, the returning columns are not beside each other, and I can't directly select them. For solving this problem, I have to use the choose function. I type choose. In the index num section, I have to specify how many columns I want to return. But keep in mind, you have to type in the columns with a specific format. Open a bracket and type in 1, comma, 2, comma, 3 and close the bracket. This structure means I want to return 3 columns. Add a comma. For the value 1, select the first column, comma. For value 2, select the second column and repeat this for the third column. Close the parentheses, comma. For the include section, I have two conditions. Open a parenthesis, and if the region is equal to India, close the parenthesis. Since I want to see both India or USA, I have to add a plus sign. Open the parenthesis and define the second condition. Close two parentheses and press enter. Now you can see the results. I hope you find this video helpful. If you did, give it a big thumb up. And if you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, please consider subscribing. Alright, it was all for today's video. I'll see you in next video.